December 7th, 1941, the United States of America was suddenly and deliberately attacked.
Japanese aircraft launch a surprise attack on the home of the American Pacific Fleet at Pearl Harbor. Within 4 hours, more than 2,400 Americans are dead. Several ships are severely damaged, and America is at war. Most people think of the attack on Pearl Harbor as an aerial assault, with bombs and torpedoes raining down from the sky. But now, the mysterious wreck of a Japanese submarine, missing for almost 70 years, has been found in the waters not far from Pearl Harbor. Did a Japanese mini-sub somehow get right inside the supposedly impenetrable naval base and sink an American battleship?
It's my conclusion after analyzing the data that this sub fired its torpedoes prior to its sinking.
It's almost like a CSI situation where we have a crime scene.
We have numerous torpedo tracks.
Can forensic science unlock the secrets of the mystery sub and for the first time reveal the true story of the attack on Pearl Harbor?
Fire in the hole!
This is the exact moment when the United States was drawn into World War II. You would think that we would know just about everything about this attack. We don't.
Oahu, one of the Hawaiian Islands, a holiday paradise in the Pacific, spectacular scenery, tropical beaches and vivid reminders of the past. For a few hours early on the 7th of December 1941, this little piece of heaven became a living hell. ...350 Japanese aircraft bombed and blasted the men and the ships in Pearl Harbor in a rain of fire. The surprise attack shook not only the entire harbor, but also an entire nation that suddenly found itself at war. Almost half of those who died that morning were lost on just one ship. The USS Arizona. It remains under the sea, a powerful symbol of a devastating day. Today, a monument is built on top of the wreck. Over 1 million people visit each year and pay their respects to the 1,177 men, most of whom remain entombed inside the hull of the Arizona below, a sunken 600-foot-long steel coffin. On board the Arizona, directing anti-aircraft guns when the ship caught fire and sank, was Don Stratton.
My hair was burnt off. I lost part of my nose, part of my ear. My back was burnt. Both my legs were burnt. It was just a hell of a day, but I don't talk about that much. So that's all I got to say about that.
But there was another part of the Japanese offensive, completely hidden from view.
Popular perception is that the Pearl Harbor attack was primarily an aerial attack coming from the sky.
It's the ultimate air raid. But a closer look at the Battle of Pearl Harbor really reveals that there's a lot more to it than that. And it also tells us a lot about the Japanese expectations, that they really wanted to completely cripple the Pacific Fleet.
Is it possible that Pearl Harbor was attacked not only from above, but also from below? Hours before Japanese aircraft carriers launched their planes north of Oahu, a secret weapon was already approaching from the south. According to military records, shortly after midnight, 5 Japanese submarines slipped undetected to within just a few miles of Pearl Harbor, each one carrying a triumph of technology on its back, a 2-man midget sub. The 5 Type A midget submarines were ingenious devices, about a quarter the length of the mother sub. Just 6 feet wide and packed with equipment, these miniature subs were designed for efficiency, not comfort. A 600-horsepower electric motor propelled the midget subs swiftly underwater at 19 knots, twice as fast as most submarines of the day. The midget subs could not only take the enemy by surprise, they could hit the enemy hard. The bow of a midget sub on display at the Naval Academy in Japan shows how.
It carried 2 Type 97 long-lance torpedoes, specially made for this midget sub.
Just one of these modified long-lance torpedoes could punch a hole in a towering battleship. But was it possible for these midget submarines to enter the supremely well-defended Pearl Harbor? Author Burl Burlingham has investigated their top-secret operation.
The midget submarines were supposed to get in the harbor, lie low, wait for the attack to happen, and then surface, fire their torpedoes into the American ships, attacking them from the bottom as well as from the top.
Was this plan successful? We know that 4 of the 5 midget subs launched that morning failed in their mission.
One midget submarine was sunk before the attack. It did not fire its torpedoes.
Midget sub number 1 was shelled by the USS Ward over an hour before the Japanese warplanes attacked. It remains where it sank, just outside the harbor. Midget sub number 2 entered Pearl Harbor, but after missing its target with both torpedoes, the sub was destroyed by a pair of American ships. It was raised 2 weeks after the attack and buried as landfill. 2 down, and another 2 would never make it even close to the harbor. Midget sub number 3 ran aground on the east side of Oahu. Its captain became the first Japanese prisoner of war. Neither of its torpedoes had been fired. The 4th midget sub turned up years later, several miles south of Pearl Harbor.
Another midget submarine was found in 1960 at Keihi Lagoon, and it still had its torpedoes in it. And that midget submarine was shipped back to Japan.
It now stands outside the Naval Academy at Etajima.
It's pretty clear that 4 of the submarines did not actually complete their mission.
What about number 5, the last of the midget subs? Petty Officer Kichichi Dewa was aboard its mother sub the night number 5 launched into battle. Dewa recorded his thoughts in a secret diary.
After long days of waiting, X day has come. The crew were dressed in clean clothes and prepared.
During the war, the Japanese were told that the 5th midget sub had scored a devastating kill.
The Japanese midget submariners became the heroes of the attack in Japan. They were given credit for sinking the USS Arizona.
Did midget sub number 5 sink the Arizona or any other American battleship that day in Pearl Harbor?
I think that cat and mouse game is still going on with historians trying to find out what happened to the 5th sub.
Now, after almost 70 years, there is a new investigation to find out what really happened in Pearl Harbor once and for all. The investigation into the mystery of what really happened at Pearl Harbor begins with Terry Kirby. He's the pilot of a submersible who's been exploring the ocean floor around the harbor for years. The area just outside of Pearl Harbor is an underwater museum of Second World War debris.
We found wrecks of airplanes and vehicles and pier parts and lots of junk.
During a routine test dive, 3 miles south of Pearl Harbor, Terry spotted something unusual.
Yeah, look at that. That's definitely a conning tower sticking. It looks like this whole end is blown off.
It was a long tube of steel, and to an expert eye, it resembled part of a Japanese midget sub. Could this be the wreck of midget sub number 5, missing since the 7th of December 1941? Marine forensic historian Park Stevenson, a former U.S. Navy officer and submariner, is going down to have a look.
Today's the day. After months of study, we're actually going down to the wreck of the midget sub that we've identified as potentially the last of the missing Japanese midget subs that participated in the attack on Pearl Harbor.
Joining Stevenson is Admiral Kazuo Ueda.
I was honored that Admiral Ueda offered to come out here. He was the senior surviving midget submariner from the war. No one knows the whole context of the Japanese midget subs better than he.
Admiral Ueda has his doubts about the find. He doesn't think it is midget sub number 5, but one damaged and dumped by American forces later in the war.
Here.
Historian Go Okamoto knows midget subs inside out.
He wrote a book on the midget submarines. He's probably the premier Japanese expert.
We'll try and get down to the bow.
Go wants to study the wreck before drawing any conclusions. Comes in.